I've never been out in this area sober.
For Dean Bullock, adventure is a way of life, and there aren't many places in his hometown of Cedar City that are unknown to him. As a celebrated Baja racer and off-highway explorer, Dean knows the dirt better than most. Today, he sets his sights on a new trail, though, and what he found was big, little, and everything in between.
We're at a place just west of Parowan, Utah, down in southern Utah. It's called the Little Salt Lake. We're out here riding the trails today. You know, there's some neat trails out here, some rock crawling, seen quite a few animals. It's been a great day. The Little Salt Lake, it got named that from the Mormon pioneers because of the salt content. It looks like the salt flats up near Great Salt Lake, but just a smaller version.
Little Salt Lake is a dry lake bed just northwest of Cedar City and Interstate 15. The long white strip is a remnant of ancient Lake Bonneville that covered much of Utah over 14,000 years ago. It's easy to find on Gap Road, right out of Parowan, and rests on the doorstep of the Parowan Gap, an incredible earthen feature that acted as a solar calendar for native tribes. There's actually evidence that people would come from hundreds of miles on the winter and summer solstice to watch the sun set directly down the center of the gap. Today, rock art covers the area, giving visitors a glimpse into the past and the chance to try and interpret what these ancient symbols may have meant. OHV trails pepper this landscape, ranging from little more than dirt roads to rocky outcroppings that can challenge the skill of even professionals like Dean.
It's a neat, unexplored area from what we've seen, I think. There's very little traffic out here, probably because of the way you have to come in around the lake. But it's a great place to come and explore and rock kick and see the animals and the different terrain. I've lived in Cedar City my entire life, and I really didn't know that there was something this neat this close to my home.
Of course, in some cases, it would make sense for Dean to have missed something like this, since oftentimes he's a little more off-road than most and traveling a bit faster than the average rider. For years, Dean has been a Baja champion, fabricating his own machines for some of the hardest and most intense cross-country races in the world. These battles are a far cry from a leisurely day of riding, but have given him the chance to test his mettle against the best in circumstances that few of us have ever known.
King of the Hammers is known as the toughest off-road race in the world, which it is. In the UTV division, there was 52 UTVs that left the starting line, and only two of us finished.
Now, there is definitely a difference between a race like King of the Hammers and a ride like we're enjoying today. At times, the scenery will fly by in both circumstances, but there's something to be said for being able to stop and take in the beauty in a more contemplative way. But then again, when you're traveling at speed, you see a lot, and you enjoy a thrill you can't get on a calmer ride. For Dean, they both have an equal but slightly different place in his exploration handbook.
I just think the advantage of riding in both is to get to see the different types of terrain. Their high desert in California is different than our high desert in Utah, so the change of scenery is nice.
Dean has obviously taken a more leisurely ride today, but in so doing, has seen sights he never knew he was missing right in his own backyard. And that's what off-highway exploration is all about, the chance to find what has never been found and see what has never been seen. Every experience is new and different, and the great thing about the West is there's always something new to discover right around the next turn in the trail. Cedar City is an excellent example of this fact.
Cedar City is in the southern part of the state, but yet it's 6,000 feet in elevation. So we can go snowmobiling up in the mountains one day, and we can come down here and ride like this the next day. We're so close to all the different types of racing. I just love it, and I feel fortunate that people love to come to Cedar City and ride, and it's something that I feel honored that I get to do.
We all have that same opportunity. We just need to set our sights on the horizon and take that first step on our next adventure. And then we'll be just like Dean, discovering something new in a place we thought we already knew. For At Your Leisure, I'm Stephen Humer. Hey guys, if you like that video, you're gonna wanna watch all of our other AYL videos. You're gonna wanna like it, you're gonna wanna share it, and you're gonna wanna subscribe, right? See all the buttons right here? This is what you're gonna wanna do,
click,
right?
Click
on them, because we have some really cool videos, all kinds of behind the scenes stuff, bloopers of Alicia crashing and stuff.
Why are you gonna sell me out like that, Steven?
So you wanna click all of these things and subscribe to our channel, because At Your Leisure is awesome, and we'll see you here for more videos.